What's up, you guys? Today we're going on a couple adventures. We are doing a coffee. Bunch of coffee type things because this is the city where they grow coffee.
Mm-hmm. They specialize in coffee, tea, and strawberries.
And this is also one of the largest distributors of coffee
in the world.
In the world,
Vietnam.
So why not? Coffee here. Most caffeinated in the world.
Most caffeinated, highest antioxidant profile.
So we're gonna go try some coffee, and then we're gonna chase waterfalls. We are here at
La Viet Coffee. They're the biggest specialty coffee in Vietnam.
And Lynn read an article about them
on the Special Coffee Association.
So we are gonna try it. Why did everybody turn and look at us when we walked in?
Because we're celebrities. I saw that too.
That's how it is in America too.
But we're American.
Yeah.
We don't fit in anywhere.
This is all coffee you guys grow and roast?
Yes, we do. We just grow.
You guys up because we specifically went to Dai Lac to try coffee.
Yes.
And then I found you guys.
Yes.
So I gotta go here.
Yes. So first, if you want a taste of coffee, I recommend you to try the espresso.
Oh, okay.
Yes. And if you want something a little bit lighter, so then you can have a drip. Maybe the V60 or the Calita is also nice. And then if you want to drink something with milk, then you can try some latte.
Let's do espresso and then
Would you say this one or this? You want the second?
The Calita.
Calita?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
So I will check one espresso and one Calita.
Yeah.
So we just got our first drink. It's an espresso. I think it's a single shot, not a double.
Is this your guys' coffee?
Yes. We all use the local coffee.
Oh wow. This has a lot of flavor.
Cheers!
Espresso is really good. Like usually 9 out of 10 times I can't drink an espresso shot because it's too bitter. That was good. This is a pour over.
Cheers!
Smooth. The other pour over was really good too.
Yeah, but like 2 days ago?
Yeah.
In Saigon.
So that was actually pretty cool because I didn't know that there was like a coffee community here. Because in the US, typically like Asian populations are about like Starbucks. And like
including my family.
Cheap coffee. But this is actually like
super cool.
Really nice, high quality. This is a roaster. They said they're developing a small community here, as you can see. Specialty coffee drinkers, and they only sell coffee from Vietnam because mm-hmm. they want to develop.
They actually grow their own, roast their own.
And
it's pretty cool. And like, she was very important. They speak really good English here, so if that's something you're afraid of, come to Dai Lac and go to La Viet.
I want to go to the farm now.
So that was part of the plan, and you didn't want to do it from the beginning.
I want to do it now.
This plan. This was the reason why we even came here was because of this place. And I even asked Vince, I was like, do you want to do the tour? And he was like, how long is it? I was like, it's an all day tour. He was like, no.
I thought it would be.
You look at how far my eyes are rolling back. I can see my brain.
So we're now in the back. This guy is trapping us.
We're prisoners.
He's going to show us around the coffee roaster.
sunlight here, so they have to put it in here to dry.
Oh, it's a dryer.
Uh-huh.
Oh.
So over here, they go through each individual green bean and they pick out by hand which ones are bad, and they take it out. See, like this one's a bad one, so he has to take it out. So he says the honey is basically they peel it and they take just the coffee bean out, and then when they roast it, there's still the sugars on the outside, so it kind of makes it caramelized and it gives it a honey color, so they call it that. These ones are the where they roast the whole fruit, the cherry, and then it gives it more of a chocolate finish. Yeah.
To Ho Chi Minh City and Hanoi.
Hanoi, oh. And, any outside of Vietnam?
Japan, mostly.
Oh, Japan.
Japan,
oh.
Buy like 70% of our product.
Oh.
70%. This year, we tried to work with a US company, Cafe Import, to sell one container.
Oh, okay.
Do you know which company? Or
Cafe Import.
Import.
The biggest importer of specialty coffee in the US. Everybody buy from them.
So maybe someday?
Hopefully.
Yeah.
When I see Vietnam coffee, I'm going to be like, yeah. Levitt, is that you? You're going to make it happen for Vietnamese people.
Yeah. That was a pretty cool experience.
I'm referring to tax tape in Vietnam.
Oh, wow.
Just thought I'd show up.
Well, that was a pretty cool experience. You got
that
to visit like all aspects of coffee right there.
It's kind of fun because I've always wanted to do that, but I'm so happy that I got to do it in Vietnam.
Yeah,
the motherland.
Everything from the growing to the processing to the roasting to the drinking, brewing, and then the drinking.
It tells you how many steps there are actually in just making coffee itself. It's not simply some coffee that you pour some hot water over. There's so many steps beyond that.
And I think that's actually why we got into coffee in the first place, because of the process, but actually visually seeing it was a whole nother thing.
Very eye-opening.
The only thing we didn't actually see is the farm.
Which at the farm, they actually do a lot more steps. There's like the fermentation step, the picking, and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But they don't do it on the weekends, so we kind of missed out.
So maybe next time. What are we doing next?
We're going to go to the waterfall.
Oh.
Chase some waterfalls.
TLC, here we come. We're here at the Cam Ly. Does that mean orange?
No.
Oh.
What's this name?
In Dalat.
Gosh.
Dalat.
They two words.
There's a lot of waterfalls here in addition to agriculture.
God.
Oh, it's a horse. Cool.
Whoa.
Oh, wow. Dang. On a horse. This looks like Karate Kid running across water.
I'm too scared.
It's actually moving.
I know.
There's a village. With the Pupi Wada. That's crazy. I wonder who lives there. Did you ever stay there?
Nope.
Like if that was a hotel?
Nope.
He's bored. He's yawning.
Huh?
He's bored. He's yawning.
Is he yawning?
I don't know. Or he's trying to chew to get free.
He's trying to chew to get free and get us.
Oh.
Oh, he's handsome.
Oh, Tung Wah.
Don't go chasing waterfalls. Here we are. This is Thak Cam Ly in Dalat. I see a creature. Right there. Climbing on rocks where he shouldn't be. He's crazy. Where is he going? Oh my God, he's hopping. What you got there, Vince? Oh dear!
Bambi's dad.
Is Bambi's dad?
He didn't actually die. He got mascara on.
He's got eyeliner.
He got eyeliner.
Thick eyeliner in his eye. Who needs a crane?
when you got a Vinsanity?
What did you say?
I said, who needs a crane when you've got B-Boy Vinsanity?
Oh. I thought she was talking mess.
I'm not talking mess. I never talk mess.
You don't?
That's not even me.
You're a mess.
You're a hot mess.
You're a hot poop.
That's nasty.
There's a picture of me as a kid on a horse looking hella angry. I'm gonna recreate it right now. I was just trying to take one photo. That guy made me do a full-on photo shoot.
I got a judgmental look right now. I'm judging you. That was everything I do not stand for.
You had me do like
20 poses.
Like 20 poses. And then he pulled a fake gun out of nowhere. That was for my mom.
That's for your mom.
That's my Vietnam present for my mom.
Cute.
I don't even think she wants it. Where are we going?
She asked if we like vegan food, and I was like, man, you are preaching to the choir.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so we're going to a vegan restaurant right now.
It's
interesting because everyone I meet here and I talk to them, either they don't realize that I'm not a local, or they're like, how do you speak such good Vietnamese?
Oh.
They're like so surprised. Like, where did you learn it from? Well, my parents. Ever since I've gone since I was little, everyone is very surprised when we speak Vietnamese because they think that if you live in another country, you grew up in another country, you don't know how to speak Vietnamese.
So we just ordered vegan pho and bum tit nung, which is it's like the vermicelli noodles, if you guys aren't familiar.
But I got it with egg rolls in
there. She got it with the egg roll. You want to try this tea?
Sure.
I wonder if it's local tea. I would assume it is.
Should be.
Cheers. It's like very smooth tea here.
Do you want to go do fish massage again? Fish foot cleaning massage again?
No.
Why?
I have phantom fish syndrome on my feet. Last night, I just kept feeling like...
You were literally shaking yesterday.
I was, like, I don't know, sensory overload. And that little white fish kept biting me. Like, this is my toes. The fish are like this. And then they go through your toes.
Ew.
So here we got vegan pho, vegan goi, which is like a salad, and vegan bum tit nung.
Bum
tit nung. With the
bum tit nung. Bum tit nung.
That one. Let's try this broth.
It's got some sriracha on there.
Ooh.
Good?
Yeah, try it. It's like very hearty.
Too far?
Ooh.
That's good.
It's like very homey tasting.
No fish were harmed in this fish sauce.
Fishless fish sauce.
I like to put my egg rolls on the side because I don't like my egg rolls soggy. You can try it?
I'm gonna try this bite with the. This is actually beef made out of gluten, wheat gluten.
Probably, yeah.
Either wheat gluten or soy.
Soy.
Not sure, but typically when I've tried this, it tastes like beef, even the texture. Mmm. This is beef. Vegan beef. It's just crazy how, like, they perfected, like, the taste and the texture of the beef. You know that a vegan Vietnamese place is legit when you see monks there. Mm-hmm. Or just a vegan place in general. If there's no monks there, then you might have to question how legit it is. And I'm being serious. Because they can say it's vegan, and then they have, like, I don't know, some type of product that's not vegan. And if you're religious, and you follow that, it might be bad. It could be a sin. It's vegan on a religious level, not a trendy level. A lot of people in America, and especially in Los Angeles, are like on this vegan trend. They're like, oh my gosh, I'm vegan. They're vegan for like, because it's cool. But here it's, when you find it for religious reasons, you find really legit food and just culture in general, because it's, again, it's on a cultural and a religious level.
You have a noodle in there.
Oh. You gave me one noodle.
Sorry.
Cheers. This is this is goy with a vegan shrimp. I don't know if that's made out of, but I'm sure it's
soy.
Soy. That reminds me of something.
A fun fact about sriracha, you cannot find sriracha in Vietnam. Like the one that we see, the Rooster brand with the green top, it's actually an American product. They don't have it at all in Vietnam. It's pretty interesting. Like, my parents are actually bringing some from America over so that they could try it here. One of the other times I've gone, somebody asked, like my sibling or I asked for sriracha, and then they were like, what is that? I was like, what the heck? They don't have it here. So they don't have it here in Vietnam. They have this other stuff that's similar.
It just kept coming. Something that's kind of funny that we've noticed is how people take pictures out there. Like, this guy, the first is a girl, and then we're like right in front of her, and then she's like, she centers us, and then she's like this.
Yeah, so, it like, didn't feel like we were photo, in the picture.
If this is the photo, we're like, our heads are just popping up right on the corner.
Like, this is how she was first, but then they want to get the scenic, so they go like this.
This is our head. That waterfall, the guy took a picture of us. And the same thing, like, he's like, huh? We're at, what is it called?
Wedding? The Married Bean?
The Married Bean. I was gonna say the wedding bean. We actually went to the factory, not the actual store, but they're gonna let us tour the factory. So even though we're not at the actual coffee shop, he actually made us some coffee that we tried. It was bomb. B-O-W-B-O-M-B.
So bummed, you can't it's spell bowed. Anymore. He was bowed. Look at these trees. They're so cool. I've never seen them before. So cool.
Right now we're about to go roll with our new friends to the coffee shop. Where are we at?
We are at the Married Bean Coffee.
Whoa, that's cool.
The owner was like super nice. We went to the wrong location. We went to their factory or their roaster area, and he was actually doing a business transaction. So he stopped and he actually talked to us, and he actually drove us here. Yeah.
We're friendly.
We're friendly. Yay.
They're not friendly. You up in boom boom boosh, boom boom. Tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. We just tried some amazing tea.
I'm feeling bamboozled because he was like, nah, the stuff you went to buy, that's no good.
But it smelled good, so I'm not mad.
I'm mad. What do we know?
But I'm pretty sure there's better. We got it from a market versus like a specialty place. But that tea was super like soothing tasting.
This been pretty awesome, Dilak.
Yeah.
Got to say.
Good coffee, good, really good tea.
Good people.
It's crazy how the cultural differences of what we're used to and what other people were telling us. Like, for example, that guy was saying that in Singapore, if you're caught with too much drugs, you get hanged.
That blew my mind because I was like, wait, I didn't even say it. I was like, wait, that's very... And I just stopped and he was like, yeah, it is still very. He knew exactly what I was thinking, but I didn't know how to say it.
You get in trouble.
That's so cool.
Some people go to jail and some people get a slap on the wrist. But it's crazy that you do it somewhere other country and think it's okay and you die.
That is mind-blowing.
That's why you gotta be smart and not do drugs.
Don't do drugs.
Ever.
Do hugs.
Yeah, hugs, not drugs. Also, pet pugs.
Yeah, I like pugs.
It's crazy to see this in the daytime because it's like all like agriculture. There's all these flowers everywhere. Last night, it was all like souvenirs, food, stuff like that. Touristy. So they literally probably around like, 5 o'clock? They probably...
6 o'clock, they said?
6 o'clock? They probably transitioned to night market hour across the crazy river of mopeds. Those fish though. We're over here at where the night market is and we're gonna at this little restaurant. It's basically like a tent with a kitchen in the back. Like we turn the screen, the street, and the restaurant. Well, we ordered ganchua, which is like the sour soup. Vegetables.
All right, friends. So we're back at the hotel. During the time we ate that food, I started to feel really yucky. It's for some reason I ordered a stir-fry vegetable plate, and the plate came out stir-fried mixed vegetables, but there is liver in there, and the liver just overpowered the entire dish. It just tasted like liver. I like liver and all. I like pate, and that's something I hardly eat in America, just because it has to be made in a specific way, very sanitary, like, manner. And so now, I didn't eat any of the liver. I just ate the vegetables, and I feel pretty yucky. How'd you feel about the food? So I guess we can't win every single time, but I'm okay if I get sick from food. I just want to at least make it worth it. If that food was like bomb, then I'm like, yes, that was worth it. But right now I'm like, oh my gosh, not worth it.
You okay?
Mm-hmm.
What happened?
I threw up.
Is it because of stupid restaurant?
Yeah. Goes to show I should follow my gut.
Oh.
My gut feeling told me.
Didn't your gut just go into the toilet?
Yeah.
So you should follow your gut into the toilet?
No!
How?
I had a gut feeling about that place. I don't know what it was. When we went up to it, I was like, I don't know if I want to eat this place.
But now you feel good?
I feel better now.
What do you want to eat now?
I want some carbs.
Okay, let's go carb it up. I'm gonna push you back. once again, we're back at this night market. Lynn threw up a couple times.
Feel better now.
Once, now she feels better, and now she's hungry. So the one thing to do is go buy some food. This looks crazy up here. There's like a million people. We got some...
Khoai mi noom.
It's cassava root, maybe?
I think it's yucca.
Yucca.
Yucca root.
It's yucca. Let's see if it's yucky. Ooh, it's yummy, not yucky.
That's pretty carby. This is cue was taken away when these guys turned the music and started salsa dancing instead.
It's like a samba party with men.
It's a what?
It's like a salsa party with only guys are invited. All the girls left.
How do you feel about the song, Vince?
I hate this song.
So you ain't gonna dance to this?
I dance like this. I don't know why I'm showing you this, but this is fascinating to me. This is the bathroom. You squat here and take a poop. Then you grab a bucket of water and you pour it in there to flush the toilet. My mind is blown.
How's the bathroom?
I showed our viewers. I showed them what the bathroom looked like. Because there's a hole in the toilet. There's a hole in the ground that you poop in.
I already told you about that. I warned you like a long time ago.
I know, but seeing...
I even told you going to the market is probably the worst place that if you ever need to go use the restroom.
I know,
you do
but...
not need to go at the market.
But seeing is believing. I've never seen it before.
You showed them that?
Yeah.
It's pretty disgusting. That's
they need
nasty.
To know. It's cool.
Did you like... Wait, is it dirty or...
Yeah.
Was it the bucket thing?
Yeah, it's like a pool of water and you just get the bucket and pour it on the poop. And the poop goes down the
this
toilet.
This is a little bit too much for our viewers.
Okay, well, I won't talk about this ever again. We have decided to once again get jiao because my tummy feels funny. So does my honey's. So you gotta disinfect the spoon. Because it make it sick. This past year, I made this dish like 5 times because Lynn taught me. But now that I know how to make it, I gotta make sure, I gotta see if it's better than mine. Or because I need to know if I need to step my game up. It's good, it's different than mine. You tell me. Different flavor. It's a Pikachu. And I don't know what that other one is. It's a baby Pikachu. Although I have yet to see anybody get hit or an accident, which is kind of crazy because I see accidents every day in LA. But people drive super crazy here and I haven't seen any accidents. That was loco.
Should we get in this car still?
I guess so.
Shall we?
We are finally back. I think Lynn feels better.
I feel better. I'm dancing.
But tomorrow we have a trip. It could be 7 hours, could be 5, or it could be 4. We don't know for sure, but it's a trip and we're gonna go on it. So.
Going in on that trip. I'm going in on that trip.
We're gonna go.
Going in on that trip.
Her village.
We left. We.
Huh?
Heard too much ghetto music.
We did?
Why am I singing ghetto?
I don't know, because you're ghetto.
I am not.
Anyways.
What you trying to say to me?
That you're ghetto?
No, I ain't.
Anyways,
Andy Vez.
I'll see you guys next time.